This is the Khan, the control room of the SSBN Colorado. This is the master brain. This is where the captain, XO.
XO on the Khan.
And all the operations are guided from.
This is where the main two characters do most of their work.
Weapons Khan, we have an authenticated fire orders.
It's a fascinating environment.
The Khan is 24 feet by 18 feet. The XO, Scott, stands here. And the keys to the missiles, you know, are right here. They have to be out of arm reach of each other. So that's where these are placed. They're 7 feet apart, and they can ignite the missile.
You hear that? She always moans a little at 1,300 feet. That's her G-spot.
Chief of Boat Prosser stands right behind there, but he's a roamer. He roams around making sure all systems are go.
Most of everything you see above us, the grates and all the pipage, appears as if it's heavy, but most of it's foam.
It took them about 5 days just to do all the wiring for the ceiling. Then you've got the video guys, because every single one of these screens that you see in the Khan is practical. They all have separate video graphics, and each graphic is designed per episode to embellish the story points of that episode.
When you look around and you see all the cabling and conduit and piping and all the stuff that's integrated in here, it's just, this is, to me, probably one of the best assets of this set.
Nobody moves.
It didn't come from one prop house. It came from numerous and salvage yards.
We were able to get a couple of companies that deal with government telecommunications.
We've cotched together some old World War II units and taken pieces off and stuck it in other things. So there's bits and pieces from battleships, earlier submarines.
We have real deal servers, monitors, communication systems.
Our lighting technicians lit up all these things and all the electronics here. If you were to go behind this set and see what's all plugged into it, it's staggering. I think we did a pretty good job here codging together with all, if you knew what was really in this place, you'd go, really?
We have everything but the real water underneath us. Jim and I see things constantly that we just go, whoa, what about that? We were sitting on a box on the side and we looked and there was a plastic folding table, molded folding table. And it was, the legs were folded and leaning up and the perforation on the underside belly. I was looking at it, he was looking at it, and we both looked at each other and go, oh my God, take it to the paint shop. So some of the walls that you see that are perforated are the backsides of folding tables, which, by the way, are economically a very wise way to do it.
The order's authenticated.
I concur.
Sweet mother of God.
So in the real boats, they've got toilet paper hanging everywhere in the Khan and other stations that have computer screens, because the condensation happens in here a lot, especially when you're down 1,000 feet, you know, with all the air conditioning and all this kind of stuff. So they needed to wipe their screens.
I was never big on the toilet paper. I'm not defending him, but he's not wrong.
If you'll remember in Crimson Tide, it was all over the place.
Visually, tough, tough.
Communications, roll out the antenna. Get us something to look at.
We shoot a new episode every 8 days. And we go through a lot of sets. To pull this off for TV is, I think, a salute to everyone on the show.
Dive, bring us up.
Aye, sir.
Helm, all ahead flank. Make your course 191.
I want them to believe, when they see this, that they're actually on a submarine.